So this problem is a challenge problem, and it's not a challenge problem because it's particularly mathematically difficult, rather the concept is really tricky to understand. We're going to be talking about escape velocity. And what is escape velocity? Well, to understand this, let's imagine a rocket on the surface of the Earth. So first, let's imagine that this rocket takes off with a very small speed. It's not going very fast. Then you can imagine that gravity pulling on the ship will cause it to slow down and fall back down to Earth. Even at greater speeds, it might take off, finally come to a stop, and then fall back towards Earth. And this makes sense because the force of gravity is always pulling on the rocket. In fact, no matter how far away the rocket is from the Earth will always be pulling on the rocket. So if we draw a force diagram for our rocket, we see that the only force acting on it is the force of gravity pulling it back towards Earth. So no matter what speed the rocket is going, it's always accelerating back towards Earth. And since it's accelerating back towards Earth, the rocket is always slowing down. So it makes sense that at some point, it comes to rest and then falls back to Earth. Even though this rocket is always accelerating towards Earth, and in fact is always slowing down, it's actually still possible for the rocket to escape the Earth forever and never be pulled back down, to just keep going away from the Earth forever. That seems like a strange idea. If it's always slowing down, how can it avoid stopping completely? Well, let's find out. So the answer to this question actually lies in this formula for gravitational potential energy that we just discussed. Now, if you remember our discussion of potential energy in the unit, we discussed how we can always set our potential energy to be zero at any point we want, as long as we stick to it. So in fact, this formula could have some constant added onto it to make it so the gravitational potential energy was zero at a specific location. So let's be smart in picking a good choice for what we want the zero potential energy point to be. So I'm going to choose a point really, really, really far away from the Earth to be where my gravitational potential energy is equal to zero. And it just so happens that this choice for a potential energy zero point happens to be when k equals zero. And let's see why. So as we get further and further away from the Earth, r, the distance from the rocket to the Earth, gets bigger and bigger and bigger, which means this value continues to get closer to zero. And the only time this value ever gets to be zero is when r goes to infinity, at some point really far away from the Earth. So that's why we don't actually need that constant k here to get that same effect. Okay, but that doesn't really explain why I chose the zero point to be off at infinity. Why wouldn't I choose it at like the surface of the Earth or something else like that? Well, let's find out how choosing our zero point for gravitational potential energy at infinity helps us reason about escape velocity. Now, once again, we're going to tackle this problem by using conservation of energy, the idea that the sum of the kinetic and potential energy is the same at any point in the problem. So for my starting point, I'm going to choose the original rocket taking off point, at which point the rocket has some initial kinetic energy and some initial potential energy. And for my final point, I'm going to choose the point when the rocket finally stops moving. The acceleration caused by the force pulling it back towards the Earth finally causes its velocity to reach zero. So at this point, there is no kinetic energy. All right, so now I want to consider a few cases of what happens if the sum of the kinetic and potential energy when the rocket lifts off has different values. First, I want to consider the case where the sum is less than zero. So if the kinetic energy plus the original potential energy is less than zero, then we know that the final potential energy must also be less than zero. And this is great because if we look at our general formula for gravitational potential energy, we see that the value is always negative because of this negative sign up front. So we should be easily able to solve for r, the distance the rocket is away from the Earth when its speed finally reaches zero. Now what about the case where the original kinetic energy plus the original potential energy is greater than zero? Well then in this case, the final potential energy must also be greater than zero. But this poses a problem. Since this formula says that gravitational potential energy is always negative, we're in trouble. How can the final potential energy be greater than zero and less than zero at the same time? The solution is they can't be. So what went wrong? Well, to get to this point, we assumed that the final kinetic energy was zero. If setting the final kinetic energy equal to zero leads to a contradiction, then it must be the case that the final kinetic energy can't ever be zero. And what does that mean? It means that the rocket never slows down to zero velocity. So even though it's always accelerating towards the Earth, it never slows all the way down and falls back to Earth. And so if the rocket never reaches zero velocity and never falls back to Earth, we can say that the rocket has successfully escaped. And that's what it means for the rocket to have escape velocity. Its original kinetic energy plus original potential energy is greater than zero. And as you might have guessed, the threshold case where the rocket has just enough velocity to escape is when the kinetic energy plus the potential energy is exactly equal to zero. Awesome. All right, now that you know this fact, you're ready to tell me what speed does the rocket need to be going in order to escape the Earth from the surface of the Earth? What's its escape velocity? And in order to solve this problem, you're going to need these constants: the value of big G, the value of the radius of the Earth, and the mass of the Earth. Good luck finding the escape velocity. And if you're confused about any of the topics I just discussed, please head to the forums and ask your questions there. I'll be happy to answer them.